Welcome to Between Two Palms. It's a pleasure to have you.
Thank you, Stephen. I'm happy to be here.
Yeah, excellent. So I want to talk to you about lots of things. I'm sure that we're going to have more things to talk about than we have time. But I want to start in a way in the beginning. I mean, many people watching are going to know you from Orange is the New Black, of course, you know, Netflix series, one of the first Netflix series. And you were in the first five seasons of the series. But you had a career as a punk rock star. You fronted for the Shirts. And I want to know a little bit about how you got started in that downtown, the Maxis Kansas City downtown world, the CBGB world. How did that all start for you?
Well, we came across the, you know, we were a Brooklyn band and we were seeing in the Soho Weekly News and the Village Voice every week, we would see, you know, reviews of bands, you know, at this place called CBGB's on the Bowery. And we thought, well, that's where we should go because, you know, we can play covers, but we have originals too. We have original music that we were playing in a storefront in Sunset Park, you know, in Brooklyn. So we ventured across the Manhattan Bridge, right up the Bowery to Bleecker, and we auditioned like everybody else did. And we had two drummers at the time. So that was unheard of. And, you know, we piled in and we auditioned. And then Hilly Crystal, who is the godfather of underground rock, he owned the club. He gave us a date and he brought us back. And I mean, the rest is history because we've played with Talking Heads and the Ramones and Blondie and Patti Smith and Television. And so we played with all the Laughing Dogs, the Ramones. I mean, so we got to play with everybody. But like you say, oh, a punk rock star. Yeah, no, we were not the cool kids. We were not at the cool kids table. No way.
Well, I've got a clip that's pretty cool, Michelle, if you'll play.
What?
Yeah, this is a clip of you from the Shirts that I just adore this. And I think that people watching will as well. Now I hear you singing a third above the rest. What was with the chewing of the gum? So were you chewing gum and singing at the same time?
I was. I did not realize until I got into legitimate theater or, you know, real music biz studio that right. That was a no-no. It was just me to keep, you know, to keep the juices flowing. Because believe it or not, you know, I would get nervous. So that's a video. And that's why I said we were not at the cool kids table. I mean, you said, oh, so you're a punk rock star. I'm like, yeah, that was a waltz. That song was a waltz. So that was our big hit in Amsterdam. And Holland was our home away from home. Yeah. We had the biggest, you know, following there in Holland. So